Kamacharyan was the natural candidate. Already they might have decided to give the ticket to George Thomas Kuttagapalli. Then Thommachan asked her, will you contest against me? Ekamma, Rosamma and Pellamma, they were called as Travancore sisters. After Kuttagapalli filed, the nomination was declared, Kuttagapalli's candidature was known, Punnus and Rosamma visited Ekamma and said, you must contest the election as an independent. This is a great injustice that had been given to you by the Congress. So you should not be a silent submissive to this kind of a thing. Then Ekamma said, no, I am not having, because by the time she was fully pregnant, she knew that she could not work. So she said that in my present condition, I cannot contest. So it is better that you find some other person. But they insisted. Finally, she agreed to contest as an independent, supported by the left. That was the way she became the candidate of the left. And she knew well, because of the political setup of those days in Palai, Kottayam, etc., it will be a safe constituency for the Congress. But still she was able to, without being present in the constituency, within a week she was admitted in Vellore. So she was not at all present in any of the election campaigns. The whole campaign was conducted by the Communist Party. That also might have been, might have gone against the interests of, naturally people thought that because the Communist Party was doing all the campaign, Ekamma might have crossed to that. Ekamma was never a communist. She was an ardent Gandhist. So what happened was, in 1953, elections Ekamma lost. But the noble story of the whole event is that Kuttagapalli won the election. Again, he was elected in 1957. One day, Kuttagapalli came to Ekamma's house. When Kuttagapalli was rising up to leave, he told Ekamma, Ekamma, don't say no to me. I know that you are living in huge debt because of the elections. I know that Punnus and Rosamma did not make money. So they were also not able to support you financially. They might have done the whole campaign. So I know very well that you have added to your debts by contesting in 1950. This is after 10 years, or almost 8 years, yeah, we can say, 61 or 62. Okay. Then Ekamma just smiled, yes. Thomas said, I have some debts, but I will take time to get it clear. No. Ekamma, I request you to do me a favor, he said. You please do me a favor. Kindly accept a small gesture of goodwill from me. Then Ekamma said, what is Thommachan you are having? He said, I have made my own enquiries and found that you have now, because of the elections in which I have defeated you, you have a debt of 40,000 rupees. 40,000 rupees. I am having that. You please clear your debt. It was the winning candidate clearing the debts of the defeated candidate. This might have never happened in the political history of India, in any place, in any elections. Okay. Then the next other elections, by-elections to Parliament, I remember, in 1970, when Panamballi died, he was representing Mugundamburam constituency, was serving at that time as law minister in Indira Gandhi's cabinet. So, when Panamballi died, it was not expected at that time. He was comparatively young, not even 70 at that time. Then came the by-election, Mugundamburam. In the Mugundamburam by-election, A.C. George was made the candidate of the Indira wing. By that time, Congress was split into two. The organization Congress under Morarji and Kamaraj and Nijalingappa, the Indira Congress under her leadership. The Indira's faction put up A.C. George. A.C. George was a trade union leader. A.C. George was, later he became a minister of state in central cabinet also, the Indira Gandhi. And then the Congress, organization Congress, with the support of the left, put Ani Thayil as the independent candidate against A.C. George. Ani Thayil was also an active Congress leader in Cochin. She was an MLA from Cochin. She was an MLA in Travancore Cochin. She was a celebrity orator, good writer. She was well known, very well known. So in many of the by-elections, we find this, on the one side, we find a celebrity woman as the candidate. So Ani Thayil contested, and it was a very hotly contested elections, unpredictable at the beginning, but finally A.C. George won the election, but I think that the majority was less than 20,000. Then A.C. George was elevated as a member of the Council of Ministers, as Minister of State for Commerce. Then another by-election to Parliament was caused by the resignation of K.R. Narayanan when he was chosen as the Vice Presidential candidate. After he won Ottapalam, taking it from the Marxist CPM. But in that election in 93, I think one former minister, N.K. Byelections, was the candidate from the Congress side. That is what I remember. And yes, Sivaraman was the candidate from the Marxist CPM. And Sivaraman won that election.
Youngest
candidate. And I think he won with a comfortable majority of over a lakh of votes. Over a lakh of votes, yes. I think that after Ottapalam, that we completed, after Ottapalam, it was a by-election in Ernakulam. Ernakulam, when Xavier Arakel, who was the MP from there, he was a barrister from England.
That again was Parliament.
Parliament. 2-3 elections we can pass on to the Assembly. That happened in 1997, I think. In that Ernakulam by-election, when Xavier Arakel died, there was intense Congress groupism between Antony and Karunakaran. It was practically two divisions. And in that election, Sebastian Ball was the candidate of the left. He was put as independent. Sebastian Ball was there. And Antony Isaac was the Congress candidate. Antony Isaac. I think he was also mayor for some time or something. Yes. And in that election, Sebastian Ball won. So, making a change in the political composition of Ernakulam constituency. Then, in the another election, George Eden was elected. But unfortunately, he died after 2 years. So again in 2003, by-election came to Parliament and Sebastian Ball was again the candidate. And M.O. John, the municipal chairman of Alway, was the Congress candidate. I think it in that election, Sebastian Ball was having television as his symbol. And Karunakaran saying that all congressmen should see the television and vote. At that time it became a very controversial statement. Karunakaran was so intelligent to convey that message to his own Congress followers that that time they expect the other one to be the candidate. So Sebastian Ball had an easy walk over that time also, over John. So that was the story of it. Then another poll to Parliament, which also may be mentioned, is that by-election which happened in 2005, Trivandrum, between Panin Ravindran and V.S. Sivakumar. Sivakumar was also sitting, but I think that it happened because of the demise of PKV. So, in that election, Panin was naturally a very popular person, non-corrupt. So he had a great image. And I think that Trivandrum is always having that kind of a political complexion which is unpredictable every time.
Some of the assembly by-elections, yes, which are very, which played crucial roles in Kerala, or after the formation of Kerala state.
Kerala, yes. I think the first by-election after the formation of Kerala state happened in Devikulam. In 1957 elections, from Devikulam, Rosamma Punnus was the winning candidate. But there was an election case, and the tribunal declared that that election was invalid. So by-election came. Again, Rosamma Punnus was the candidate of the Communist Party. At that time, there was no division between CPI or CPM. It was all communist. And in that election, Congress put up, because of the complexion of Devikulam constituency, it was more a labor-friendly constituency.
Basically, tea plantations.
Tea plantations, alum, cardamom plantations, and so on. And Kannan Devan and other, so many state employees were there. Half Tamil voters. A sizable section was Tamil voters, because these Tamil laborers were brought from Tamil Nadu, and they were also constituting a large group. And at that election, because Rosamma Punnus and P.T. Punnus were in the field of trade union, the natural sympathy of the majority of the labor wing was supposed to be with them at that time. So the Congress thought of putting a B.K. Nair. He was a well-known INTUC leader at that time. B.K. Nair was also a celebrity trade union leader whose political image was also very clean. So it was a very hotly contested election.